songwriter, poet, and playwright. Fading settings of these poems are rich in their harmony. You will hear influences of Poulenc, Ravel, and Debussy. Color and text painting. The poems are long and vivid. We have chosen to read each poem before we perform them to better engage you with the story. Just as the composer intended, we please ask you to refrain from applause until we have finished singing the final of the three pieces. And before we start, this is my last Voces concert as a Rowan University student. I'd also like to acknowledge Allie, Nina, and Chris, as this is their last concert with Voces as well. And I would like to thank all my peers, and especially Dr. Thomas, for making this experience unforgettable. And to everyone else who is performing in Voces for the last time, it's been an honor sharing the stage with you. Please enjoy.
The night at sea. The breeze swells our sail. Behold the first star that twinkles upon the waves that rock us. Friends, let us sail the night in silence. All noises have become silent. One would say that everything on earth is dead. Humans as well as things, birds as well as roses, all are asleep. But the sea, it is the living. It is the immensity, shifting constantly, taking the piers by storm, disdainful of the nights and days. Except for her, nothing exists but the large lighthouse and its sad reflection. At the best place, my friends, let us now throw our net. Then, with our sails furled, our faces bare beneath the stars, let us sleep. Dream upon the deep peace of everyone we love in this world below. Let us sleep on our schooners as in our childhood cradles. And tomorrow at high tide, we will rally to the shore triumphant.
Of the water of water, for sea. lament of the souls. Virgin Mary, O good Mother of Jesus, here is the bitter lament sung by those who no longer exist. We come upon this autumn evening to knock at the doors of our friends. It is Jesus Christ who commands us to awaken the sleepers. Ah, you who sleep in the black night, ah, dream from time to time that in purgatory's blazing fires are, perhaps, all your parents. They are there, your fathers and your mothers, fire above and fire below, hoping in vain for the prayers that they have a right to expect from you. Dream that perhaps they say to all Christians here on this world below, pray for us without knowing us, because our children do not. We have been left in purgatory. Pray for those who do not pray. Pray for us. Pray without ceasing, because our children are the ungrateful ones.
Summer evening. Lisons, my pet, let us leave the hill, for the day is waning at the red horizon. Let us seize the moment before it dies. Come, let us linger, my Lisons. In the immense peace of the evening's onset arises the romance of the little crickets.
and the flat plain that Phoebus sets ablaze savors the ecstasy of the last rays. The charming voices come from the oak trees. They are the lullabies of the little birds. And with her door closed, Rose, the farmer's wife, sings the same thing between two cradles. It is the pristine hour when the branches pass the murmur of the great calmed wind. The languorous hour when the lover hangs happily on the arm of her beloved. It is the touching hour when everything enchants us, when the bells sing the Angelus in the distance. And it is the gray hour when the gentle breeze impregnates and intoxicates itself with the smell of hay. It is the hour when everyone loves, when, tired of blasphemy, the evil one himself is even a little better. The heart strips itself of everything that soils it. The soul itself kneels before the Lord. Lison, my little one, let us pray for good quickly, so that we will not be separated for eternity, and that we may be invited to flee this life and the ravishing hour of a beautiful summer's evening.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I am thrilled to be here tonight in front of Rowan University Chorus. You just heard Mozart's concluding portion of the Agnus Dei movement of the Mass in C, which Mozart composed in 1776 at age 20. And so about their age. And it featured assistant pianist Quinny May. And our next number goes back in time a little bit, Hassler's Dixie Maria. He was a German composer and organist of the late Renaissance, early Baroque period, who studied extensively in Venice. And this motet was part of a collection of some of the first published motets called Sacred Songs that were published in 1591. So here is Dixie Maria.
Thank you.
Morrison set three poems to a musical cycle called Nocturnes, and Sure in the Shining Night is the third of the set. The beautiful poetry by James A.G.E. describes a winter night with all its beauty under the stars. The premiere of this piece was at the Los Angeles National ACDA Convention in 2005, and it features our pianist, Alex DiStefano.
Thank you.
Okay. Death Came a Knockin' is a traditional African-American spiritual. It was American blues icon Ruthie Foster released her arrangement of Death Came a Knockin' on her 2002 recording Runaway Soul. Then Paul Raridan, who is the director of choral activities at Temple University, worked with her in adapting Foster's arrangement for an SATV setting. This selection features Grace Raymond, Emma Seidel, and Victoria Alexander. So we hope you like this version of Death Came a Knockin'.
Sister stooped down, buckled up her shoes, and she moved on down by the Jordan stream, and then she shouted, Hallelujah, done my duty, got on my traveling shoes.
selection we're going to do for you is called Sanctuary. It's written by Jason Robert Brown, who is a well-known Broadway composer. And it was written for an album called Coming From Inside the House, a virtual subculture concert. So he didn't write it for a musical, but he wrote it during that time, right at the height of the pandemic, when choirs were doing virtual kinds of recordings. And that's where it comes from, and the lyrics, I think, relate to that time, if you listen to it, helping people get through some tougher things. So the featured quartet in it are Bethel Bishay, Madeline Reddy, Andrew Beccaro, and Jack Colliton. And it also features pianist Alex DiStefano. So, and
children crying.
Before our last number, I just want to acknowledge a few people. Our assistant pianist, Quinny May, our pianist, Alex DiStefano, our university chorus student assistant, Justin Kerbensate, the three of them for their leadership and hard work. The wonderful staff running the house here in every way, from sound to everything else, stage managing, backstage, thank you. I want to thank Dr. Chris Thomas for his choral expertise and support of myself and the university choir. And the wonderful students of Rowan University Choir. Thank you for your hard work and dedication and to excellent music making. I am looking forward to next semester already. So thank you for your hard work. Bride in the Chariot is our last number. This is Brandel Waddell's arrangement, which honors the traditional spirituals of the past while utilizing some modern gospel and jazz chord structures. Featured soloists are Hannah Potraits, Sean Feeney, Jenna Johnston, and Isabel Kerr, as well as pianist Alex DiStefano. I hope you like Ride in the Chariot.